Hey there, Pokemon trainers. What is up? This is Trainer Connor, and you're about to watch my very last Wi-Fi battle video for the Kanto Classic Wi-Fi competition. If you enjoy this Wi-Fi battle, you can hit that like button and subscribe. I really appreciate it. Now, if you have not seen my other matches, I would recommend checking them out. They're going to be in the same playlist as in this video. But this particular match was actually one of the best battles I had throughout the competition. Out of 30 matches, I think this one was the best one. It came down to the wire, it came down to the very last turn of the match. And yeah, so let's get started here. I'm gonna start out with my Nido King as my opponent here, as you saw, starts off with a Nido Queen. Nido King is going to be faster because it is faster in general than Nido Queen, and we're able to knock it out with an Earth Power. So Nido King is definitely better than Nido Queen, and there's a perfect example of that. Okay, so the only Pokemon that can actually take on an Alakazam is actually my own Alakazam. So I end up switching on it, and holy crap, that does a lot of damage. I don't know what it is, but my Alakazam, yeah, it's a timid nature, so I am running a lot more speed than Special Attack, but I outspeed all the other Alakazam, which is pretty weird, but I believe that's the case with my nature and all that. So I realized that he went for an encore to lock myself into Shadow Ball, and I know his strategy and going to Snorlax. I end up predicting that and going to Machamp for the typing matchup, really. And I didn't want to go for a Dynamic Punch yet because of Clefable. So even if he wants to set up, this Nidoking can take a plus one Psyshock. And we see that coming here shortly. Yeah, we barely take him out there with a Sludge Bomb, and we see that this Psyshock, I barely live with 28 or 29 HP there. It's hard to tell by looking at the screen there, but nevertheless, we still hang on with a little bit of HP, but his Zapdos can come in and revenge kill. I chose this to be a switch out for, I don't know what I'm saying. Wow. I switched out. Yeah. And we go into Clefable. So, yeah. Okay, that worked. Why was that so hard to say for some reason? We switch out into Clefable. Yeah. And we take that HP Ice pretty well. And we're able to set up here, which is great. We force him out into Lapras. And immediately, I know Sheer Cold. Because Sheer Cold, it's a 50% chance. It's a one-hit KO of a move there, and I am really fortunate because two times in a row we're able to dodge the Sheer Cold, and we are able to retaliate back and take out Lapras. I was so relieved by that. Now I could have switched out and gone into Machamp again. But I thought that was way too obvious. I think my opponent predicted that, so he went for a curse that turn. But I stay in and go for a Moon Blast. I go for Flamethrower. Yeah, I know the ability of Thick Fat on Snorlax, but I was actually fishing for the burn. That's why I went for that. But no dice. It's kind of a risky move there, but I did it. And yeah, so we're moving on. So here's Machamp. I thought I could bring him and we're here, and hopefully we'll get paralyzed, and we don't get paralyzed, hooray, and we're able to go the Dynamic Punch, finish off the Snorlax. Okay, so Zapdos is here again, and I was skeptical on what moves that this thing had. I dodge a Thunderbolt, and we get hit by HP Ice. I was actually expecting the Air Slash, if he had it. I've seen Zapdos run Air Slash. It's not common, but it's still something that Zapdos can get. It can also get Air Cutter, which will increase in power if you go more than one turn in a row. So if you go with a first their color, you'll get like 25 damage, and then 50, 75, 100. I was really skeptical of the moveset that the Zapdos had, so just saying. But anyway, so Snorlax is going to get poisoned here, which puts him on a timer, because I am toxic and I will be taking damage every turn. Here, I keep going for Curse, and that's going to bite me here, because this Alakazam, if you saw from earlier, he has Encore, and what that does, it allows you to keep on using the same move you've used the last turn. So, we went for Curse the last time, we're going to keep on using that. Not something I expected, but like I should have paid more attention to detail there. But yeah, so we're gonna basically stay in here and go with a curse. I could switch out there, but really it's an Alakazam. I could go into my own Alakazam, but we saw the damage that it did and it was resisted. So I'm gonna sack off Snorlax. I'm sorry, buddy, but that had to be done. And now we can go into my own Alakazam because I know I'm faster than it. And just fire away with a Shadow Ball. We do hit Zapdos. But Zapdos has a lot of really good special bulk. And we definitely see that shining through here. Because look at that. It's a Shadow Ball and a Psychic. And we don't take him out. Unfortunately. And we lose Alakazam. But that's okay. He only has Zapdos and his own Alakazam left, so if I can survive this Thunderbolt, we can take him out with that Moonblast, but unfortunately, he still has Alakazam. Goes for a Psychic and just takes out Clefable. I'm like, okay, this is going to suck, because the last Pokemon is Golem. All he has to do is click Psychic. He went for Taunt. I was surprised by this. I don't know. I don't know anymore. What? It's ridiculous. I won the match, yes, but he would have won there if he went for Psychic. For some reason, he went for a Taunt. No, I don't even know what Pokemon is anymore. Yeah, so that happened. When I was finished with the battle, I was like shocked for like 10 minutes. I was like looking at the screen like, what just happened? You would have won the match here if you clicked the psychic type move, but he didn't go for it. It's a tiny mistake there that he went for it. Okay, so that's the game. I hope you guys enjoyed. The next Wi-Fi competition that I know of is the ICL, not to be confused by the league that I'm part of, which we are restarting because of dropouts, which, really, if you don't make time for it, why are you in it anyway? But we're restarting our ICL league. The new draft will be coming out here shortly. We're still in the draft. I'll get my analysis up here real soon. But the ICL and Wi-Fi competitions, as far as that goes, that's the International Challenge. The International Challenge of March is coming up. It is the VGC-style double battle format where you get to use legendary Pokemon. I'm actually debating on whether I should participate or not. I'm still going to think about it, but in the meantime, I'm actually not going to participate until I change my mind. So we'll see how that goes. And like I said, the ICL League I'm part of, the matches that I posted on my channel are unofficial because we had to restart because of dropouts and, yeah. Okay, so that's the game. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys in the next video. If you enjoyed, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more Wi-Fi battle videos. Have a great day, trainers. I'll see you soon. Goodbye.